Hello everyone, let's study the new one topic, that is convolution theorem of the Laplace transform. This is one of the property of the LT. So let's start with this topic. If Laplace of f of t is equal to f of s, and suppose there is another function, we consider that function as a g of t, and the answer for that Laplace of g of t is equal to g of s. Then Laplace of integral from 0 to t function of u into g of t minus u du is exactly equal to the multiplication of these f of s and g of s here, and also it is equal to the Laplace of integral from 0 to t function of t minus u into g of u du. So here what happened, we simply interchange these two parts here, f of u and g t of u. So here what happened, we are considering function of t minus u and here g of u. So there is a change in these two functions here. Now let us consider one question for these theorem, so you will clearly understand what is the convolution theorem is. Verify the convolution theorem for f of t is equal to t and g of t is equal to e raised to at. Now according to these theorem, first find out the Laplace of the given function of t and g of t, and after that write down these statement f of s into g of s. That means you will get one part of the convolution theorem here. So let's start here. So in this step number 1, we will find out the Laplace of our functions. So here Laplace of f of t, which is equal to Laplace of t and which equals 1 upon s square. So here we use the formula for Laplace of t raised to n, okay, which is equal to f of s. So indicate these Laplace of t as a f of s. Now after that, similarly find out the Laplace of your e raised to at, so which is equal to 1 upon s minus a, and indicate these function as a g of s here. So what happened, in the first step we will find out the multiplication of our answers, that means f of s into g of s here. So here we first write down what is the convolution theorem is. So that means this is my convolution theorem, okay. Now after that I will find out the answer here. So this is the answer, f of s into g of s is equal to 1 upon s square into 1 upon s minus a, and write down these as a step number 1 here. Now in this step number 2, we simply replace the t parameter by u and t minus u. So suppose if you are going to consider these integral, so here integral from 0 to t f of u, what does it mean? Simply replace the t parameter, that means f of t is equal to t दिया है, तो हम क्या करेंगे, f of u लिखेंगे. So what does it mean, t parameter is replaced by u parameter, okay. And after that, if there is the function g of t minus u, so what does it mean, replace the t parameter in the g of t by t minus u. So here you will get e raised to a in between bracket t minus u. So in this step number 2, we will use this part here, okay. So again here I am going to mention these steps here. What is the f of t? F of t is equal to t here. So we are going to change this parameter by the u variable. So here we will write down, therefore function of u is equal to u, okay. Simply replace the t by u here. Similarly, what is your g of t? G of t is equal to e raised to at, okay. So what is the value of g of t minus u? So simply here we change the value of t parameter by t minus u here, okay. So simplify here, you will get the answer e raised to at into e raised to minus a u here. Now we will write down our integral part, that means Now, Laplace of integral from 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du. Integrating factor is u parameter here. So, we will find out the integral first. So, that means here we get the answer. Laplace of integral in between bracket 0 to t f of u means u into g of t minus u means this function. So e raised to a t into e raised to minus a u. Now in the next step we will find our answer. So what happened here? E raised to a t, your integrating factor is the u parameter, correct? So e raised to a t is a completely scalar, that means it is a scalar. So that's why here we will write down e raised to a t, that is the most one important part here, okay? So Laplace of e raised to a t is my scalar, integral of 0 to t then u into e raised to minus a u du here, correct? Now here we will use integration by part. So according to the rule LIATE, L means what? Logarithmic. I means what? Inverse. A means algebraic. T means trigonometric and E means exponential. So that means the order is correct here. Okay, this is the algebraic and this one is your exponential. So order for the integration by part is right here. So we will simply use the integration by part rule. So what is that rule? Integral of u into v dx is equal to u integral of v dx minus integral in between bracket, again we will find out the integral of v dx into derivative of u into here integrating factor is x. So that is the rule of integration by part. Now here we will apply the same rule for these u into e raised to minus au to find the integral of this function here. So these e raised to at remains as it is, okay? Now according to rule, u integral of e raised to minus au minus integral in between bracket, again we will find out the integral of e raised to minus au and derivative of u here. Now after that we will apply the integration. So integration of e raised to x is e raised to x here. But what happened here? E raised to minus au, that means it is the composite function. So that's why we will find out the derivative of minus au in the denominator here. So derivative of minus au is minus a here. Now similarly, we will find the answer for this function. Integral of e raised to minus au is equal to e raised to minus au upon minus a. And derivative of u is 1 here. Okay. Now these minus minus will become plus in the next one step. So here we will write down that point also. So that means this parameter remains as it is. Laplace of e raised to at in between bracket u into e raised to minus au upon minus a. These minus minus plus. Now 1 upon a is the scalar here and again we will find out the integration of e raised to minus au. So after finding this we will get the answer like this. Okay, so that means this is my answer. Now I am going to substitute the value of u parameter as t again, that means upper limit and after that lower limit. So here after applying the upper limit as a t parameter and lower limit as a 0 parameter for the u, we will get the answer like this. So here u is replaced by t into e raised to minus a t upon minus a minus 1 upon a square e raised to minus a t. Now this is for the upper limit. Now we will put the lower limit as a 0. That means the value of u parameter is 0 here. So 0 into this term minus again here. We will write down for the second part. Now after that we will simplify it. So these e raised to a t remains as it is. Then the first one term is again as it is here. Okay. So these bracket remains same. Now in the second part what happens? 0 into this term, that means the whole answer for this term is 0 and these minus minus will become plus here. Okay, so and e raised to minus a into 0, that means e raised to 0. So we will write down that part here. Okay, now we will multiply this e raised to at with the inner terms here. So let's start here. Now t into e raised to at into e raised to minus at upon minus a. Now after that multiply this e raised to at with the second one term. So here I will write down minus 1 upon a square e raised to at into e raised to minus at plus 1 upon a square e raised to 0 into e raised to at here. Now again use your law of indices, that means e raised to at minus at, that means it will become e raised to 0. So after applying the law of indices we will get the answer like this. Now again here put the value of e raised to 0 as a 1, so definitely you will get the answer, simplified answer here like this. Okay, so finally we get the answer Laplace of minus 1 upon a t minus 1 upon a square plus 1 upon a square e raised to at here. Now in this situation what happened, minus 1 upon a or 1 upon a square, these are the scalars. So here we use our properties, Laplace properties. So what happened, minus 1 upon a Laplace of t. So find the answer for the Laplace term and scalar out of the Laplace. Okay, so Laplace of 1 plus 1 upon a square Laplace of e raised to at. So what is the Laplace of t here, 1 upon a square. Laplace of 1 is 1 upon s and Laplace of e raised to at is 1 upon s minus a. So that means this is my answer here. Now in the next step we will find out the LCM of these whole term. So let's find it. Again here I am writing for the simplification part. So just these are my terms here. Now here I want to multiply with the a square because in the denominator a square is involved. So ab hame kya karna padega, denominator mein hum a ke sath yahan pe multiply karenge and for these term we are going to multiply for the s. So at the same time we will think for the third one step also. So what happened, in the denominator there is the s minus a for the third term and in these two terms it is missing here. So that's why simultaneously I am finding the LCM for these three terms here. So let's start. Minus a, yahan pe a missing tha to humne kisse multiply kiya, a ke sath. A square as it is hai, correct. What is missing, s minus a is missing, so multiply with that term. Now in the second term in the denominator a square hai, s square चाहिए था हमें, तो अब हम किसके साथ मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, यहाँ पे s के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे एंड s माइनस a के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. सो s इन बिटवीन ब्रैकेट s माइनस a. नाउ फॉर द थर्ड टर्म व्हाट हैपन, ओनली s स्क्वायर इज रिमेनिंग हियर क्योंकि a स्क्वायर भी प्रेजेंट है, s माइनस a ब्रैकेट भी प्रेजेंट है. सो व्हाट इज मिसिंग हियर, ओनली s स्क्वायर इज मिसिंग. सो राइट डाउन इट. नाउ आफ्टर दैट find your answer, simplify it. So what happened, minus as and plus as will be cancelled, similarly minus a square and plus a square will be cancelled. After that you will get a square upon these your denominator as it is, again we will cancel these. Okay, now finally we get 1 upon a square into 1 upon s minus a. This is the answer for your multiplication of the Laplaces of t and Laplace of e raised to at that we already find in the step number 1. So according to the step number 1 and 2 what we will get, we will actually verify our convolution theorem here. I hope all of you understand it. Thank you.